There's nowhere at all I'd rather be today than here at Hockenheim for the German Grand Prix. We have an incredibly competitive field this year, which means we should be in for a treat. And judging by the sea of people filling the grandstands, there's a fair-sized chunk of Germany that agrees with me. It's 2.8 miles around the Hockenheim ring then, with an average lap speed in excess of 130 miles per hour. The long curved back straight leads into a tight hairpin for the best overtaking opportunity on the circuit. But there are plenty of other options available around the 17 corners here today. And I'm joined once again by Anthony Davidson to bring you the lowdown for today's race. Let's talk about Parker. As with all the drivers at this level, they have a lot of ambition, but Formula One's a daunting step up from any other series, so expectations are high right from the start.
That's right, it is a difficult environment to come into. In junior categories, you're competing against drivers with similar levels of experience, but some of these guys in Formula One have been there for over a decade. But I have to say, in this case, it's so far so good.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Parker, Valtteri Bottas, and Hamilton, Albon, Weber, Hülkenberg, and Sergio Perez. Norris, Stroll, Kimi Raikkonen, and Grosjean, Sainz, Russell, Kevin Magnussen, and Daniel Kvyat, Ricciardo, and Devon Butler starts from the back of the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
This is our engine supplier's home Grand Prix. Let's give them a race worth watching. Okay, entering lap 3 now. DRS has been enabled. Is going to be down slightly and showing some minor wear. Is 1.5 seconds. They're on fresh softs. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. 2 laps left. Next time by will be your final lap. Position, front of the pack, Leclerc behind. They're on fresh softs. This is your final lap of the race. Consecutive win. You are just having an amazing season. Enjoy this feeling while you can.
Brilliant stuff from Williams today. What a superb victory. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Oh, here they are now. I always love seeing the independent teams do well. Williams have a long and storied history with F1, and I'm delighted to see them on the top step of the podium. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Parker increases their championship lead. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
There's a few contenders, but George Russell definitely stood out, I think. A really solid drive from him today, and one I'm sure the fans enjoyed. Look at where they finished compared to where they started. It's not easy to cut through the field like that in Formula One, so it was a great effort.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts.
You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you?
It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? Great. Well, that's everything.